So I think my cardinal sin is talking too much. So magta-timer ako. Sabi sa akin ni Ann, 30 minutes lang. So good luck.
This kind of topic is normally very difficult to discuss in just 30 minutes, but I'll do my best. Unfortunately, Ann set us off in a very dark mood, which I will add to. Kasi ganun. I was in a coffee shop with my laptop, working a little bit, waiting for my car to be finished being washed. It was a legitimate car wash. And when I came in, there were 6 police officers having coffee. And one dumagat. I understand may dumagat tayo ngayon. Lady dumagat. And one of the lines that I heard that got my blood boiling was, kahit ano pwedeng gawin dyan, basta pagkakitaan. So, of course, you put 2 and 2 together, the presence of the dumagat and the police officers, and where they were, one can only conclude na yun na nga yun, land grabbing operations and whatnot. Unfortunately, I have a bad back. I have gout and I have 2 kids and they have guns. So I couldn't do anything as much as I wanted to. But this is my way of fighting back, so to speak, gladly accepting the invitation to speak in front of you. This was given to me by my boss, who owns the school I work in. I've been there since 2004. 30 years na po yung school. We are in Beverly Hills, not in the US, but in Antipolo. Okay. The school is in Taytay because the gate of the subdivision is in Antipolo. So medyo ano kami. And correct, one of several of our students have been going back and forth helping out Masungi with their advocacy. Lulu Arellano, just to mention names, and Raya Dichoso have been helping out surveying the area, and some of you might encounter their names when you peruse online videos, documents published by Masungi. No? So they were engaged in actually training some of their rangers. So these are college students, and they started studying the area when they were grade 12, grade 11 with us. Okay, so I've been asked to give you an overview of Philippine biodiversity, and I must say from the very start that these words are not mine. I am standing on the shoulders of giants, Larry Heaney and Jacinto Regalado Jr., mostly Heaney, who works in the Chicago Field Museum of Natural History. So they came up with a book, and it's a very nice read. If you want, you can look for it in archive.org. Unfortunately, it's out of print already. Pero they're coming up with a web version. So the book was released 1998. And they say that they are putting in new findings that they've accumulated the past 15 years. And it's really very exciting work. So the team of Larry comes here to the Philippines, spends several weeks in the mountains. He's 70 plus years old. Typical Santa, white everything. And they discover left and right new species. In fact, they have a backlog of specimens in Chicago waiting to be described. Ganon ka-rich yung diversity ng ating bansa. Biodiversity. I assume we know already what this means, no?
Alam niyo ba kung ano yung biodiversity?
Yes, alam ba natin?
Okay lang kung hindi, kasi we're
both. Pasensya na, baka kasi isipin niyo bata kayo at matanda na ako. Eh, ganun minsan pag teacher, eh, no? So, class, what does biodiversity mean? So, bio is?
Life,
no? And diversity is? Diversity, pagkakaiba-iba. No? Samot-saring buhay ligaw. Kasi ayaw natin ng mga buhay na nasa Bakuran, si Muning, si Kuting, si Polgas. Ayaw natin ng domesticated. So, buhay ilang, wildlife. Which reminds me na yung itatayong bilibid, kakaibang wildlife yung mapupunta. Anyway, so that's the book, and I'm trying to rehash a little bit of the book this morning for you. So the Philippines has been classified by Conservation International last 1988 as a mega diverse country. So when we say mega diverse, we mean that it holds a lot of different kinds of animals and plants found nowhere else. So pag sinabing found nowhere else, that's endemic. Of the 17 mega diverse countries, we can probably give them a copy kasi they're trying to take photos. Medyo hindi maganda yung resolution from screen, but if you want a copy of the slides, I'll be more than willing to give to you. So the Philippines is one of the 17 mega diverse countries. However, a lot of studies and a lot of experts are now saying that of the 17, one can argue that the Philippines is at the top. So we have this table, it's old data already. This is from the book and it was published 1998 pa. So we have those very high endemicity rates or percentages. This is endemic percentages. So as you can see across the board, more than half, sometimes more than 3/4 of all living things are found only in the Philippines. Nowhere else in the world, only in the Philippines. And this is only the most obvious of the animals, the tamaraw, the tarsier. Hindi pa dito kasama yung paborito ng Diyos. Sabi nga nila, God is a Beatles fan. Because 1 out of 5 living thing is a bug or a beetle. So wala pa yun, wala pa yung mga insekto, wala pa yung mga kulisa. When I brought my team using the money of National Geographic to one of the ancestral lands of the Dumagats in Santa Ynez, one of the researchers, friend of mine from UP, discovered a new cockroach, forest cockroach, hindi yung sa kanya. Genus, hindi species. So it's like saying the dog is found only in the Philippines. Parang ganun, no? That's a lousy analogy, but you get my meaning, no? So cockroach genus, found only in that area. So, ganun ka yaman ang ating lugar. Let's have a bit of comparison. So, compared to the entire European continent, we have more. More that is unique. Now, as you can see there, Spain has 28 endemic species. 28 lang. Okay. Yung ibang mga European countries, tag-isa-isa lang. So, total nun is 78. The Philippines has 510. Compared to area, Europe is 35 times bigger. Okay, so that's one. Another point of comparison is Brazil. Ano ang meron sa Brazil? Bakit importante ang Brazil in terms of diversity? One of the biggest rainforests that is now being converted to your T-bone steaks. Okay, can we all clap? Follow the beat. Okay. Amazon rainforest, the size of a football field. America, national football, something. Ano yung tawag sa sport na yun? Yung banggaan?
Rugby.
No, yeah. Oh, with the helmet. Football. Football na alam ko kasi is soccer. Bear, American football. Every time we do that, an Amazon rainforest, the size of an American football field, is cut down and destroyed. As we speak. Ganun kabilis yung destruction ngayon sa Amazon. Brazil is 28 times larger than the Philippines, but we have 20 times more unique species. Okay. Mas sikat lang sila. Mas kilala.
Kaya actually, sabi nila when we talk about Philippine biodiversity, you're talking about yung hindi lang heritage natin, diba? But really heritage
global.
Of the world.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Sino ang medyo bata pa dito? Young Ones and Young Ones. Medyo familiar tayo sa poster na to, I guess. No? Madagascar, nakailang parts na yan. No? And then, these are very famous characters. These are actually mammals found in Madagascar, sikat na island. Compare the statistics, 40% and 64%. Madagascar is twice the size of the Philippines. So, bakit ganun? So, how did we come to this point that we have such riches in our country? So, the key is isolation. So, class. Ano sinabi ni Darwin tungkol sa evolution? And where does isolation come in?
Islands.
So, let's say, nagkaroon dito ng earthquake and nagkaroon ng malaking ilog. No? At even if may crush ka dito sa kabila, hindi mo siya pwedeng ligawan, no? At hindi kayo pwedeng magkaroon ng anak. Now, prolong that for thousands of years, reproductive isolation, magiging ibang-iba na ang itsura ninyo until maski gusto nyo man magsama, hindi na kayo magkakaanak kasi ibang-iba na ang itsura ninyo. So, ganun po ang ating speciation. It all starts with isolation. So, if one population is isolated from another, they can no longer interbreed and that begins the process of speciation. So, here, in this study of the Galapagos Islands, dito po si Darwin naglagi, no? Sa isa sa mga pinuntahan niya sa kanyang HMS Beagle ship, no? And we have here different finches, isang uri ng ibon, na sinasabing napunta by accident, sweepstakes, no? Accidental colonization from the mainland of Ecuador to the islands of Galapagos. No, siguro, lumilipad-lipad siya, binagyo, hinangin, naligaw ng landas, napunta sa islands. And that occurs very rarely, but it does occur. No? Some studies have shown that frogs can cross oceans on rafts of vegetation. Kapag bumagyo, may nabubuwal na troso, mga puno, and then they hitch a ride. They hitch a ride across the oceans and go to other islands in the Pacific. So that kind of sweepstakes events, yung very rare chance, leads to colonization and eventual speciation in the different islands. So ganun ang nangyari sa mga Galapagos finches. So pag napunta ka sa isang lugar at merong minalot, you will learn to eat it. Sa kabilang lugar naman, may pritong salagubang, Ilocano ko eh, no? So, may pritong salagubang, yun ang matututunan mong kainin. Oh, at sa ibang lugar, may kinilaw. So, if as you learn to adapt to the resources available, you become more specialized, your body changes as well. So, yun, nagkakaroon ng speciation. So, isolation is key to the richness of Philippine biodiversity. Because, yeah, the Philippine Islands have always been isolated from each other and the rest of the world. So, Pangaea. Ano po yung Pangaea? Audience participation. Those with the most points will get will get the coffee table book. I'm sorry, akin na daw to sabi ni hindi. Yes, the supercontinent, di ba? From which everything came. So, all the land masses are there. Pangaea means all of the earth. Pangaea, all of the earth put together. But the Philippines was not part of it. Only Palawan. And in the present day, we have very, very deep channels separating islands. Sino po ang nakakapunta sa southernmost tip of Luzon? Anong bayan yun? When you go driving and then you ride the Roro.
Matnog.
Okay, the very...
Matnog.
Yes, oo. Tapos pwede kang sumigaw, may talaw ka, pero Visayas na yun. Ano po yun?
Samar.
Samar. No? And that channel is very deep. So deep that animals and plants cannot cross it even if conceivably pwede mong batuhin yung kapitbahay doon. No? So ganun ka tindi yung isolation ng present day islands natin. And mountains. And more than islands, we have mountains. And each mountain is further isolated in itself. So we'll talk about that a little later. So let's take a look at this. This is from, again, this is not mine, from Robert Hall of the Royal Holloway University of London. So he made a study of the geologic origins of Southeast Asia. So plate tectonics. Tingnan natin kung ano yung malalaman natin when we look at it. Ah, nakabukas na pala. Ayan. So the Philippines was said to have arisen around 55 million years ago. So sabi dito sa ating coffee table book, the limestone formations we have around us are 60 million years old. So this is not an exact science. Give or take 10 million years, no problem. So 55 million years ago, the very first islands arose. The very first Philippine islands came from the bottom of the ocean. Sino po ang nanood ng Moana? Okay, yeah, malalaman natin kung sino mga bata. Okay, merong character doon, demigod, si Maui. And according to Polynesian culture, one of his powers is to, using his magical fish hook, fish out and pull islands from the ocean. So yun po ang nangyari sa Pilipinas. So the very first group of islands is Samar, Leyte.
Oh, okay.
Dito siya, where I think close to Hawaii is now. Doon siya nagmula. Tapos lumakbay siya, so that's 55 million years ago. Tingnan ko kung nakikilala din ninyo itong kulay dilaw na to.
Palawan.
Palawan. The only part of the Philippines that came from Pangaea.
Kaya iba yung...
So 55 million years ago, 54 million years ago, 53, 52, 51, then came Masungi out of the bottom of the ocean. This is Luzon. And tinatamad pa siya noon, nakahiga pa siya. So Luzon actually went upright and down several times. So of course, Masungi, these are limestone formations and they came from the bottom of the Pacific. These were coral reefs. No? That because of uplifting 50 million years ago. Okay. Kaya maraming mga ganun, no? Okay. So never before part of Pangaea. So when the animals and plants were moving around Pangaea, interbreeding, hindi nila alam na may Pilipinas. Well, meron na. Hindi lang nila mapuntahan. Because everything else was connected by a big landmass. Philippines, kailangan mo ng boat. To reach. 49, 48, 47, ayan. Sisimula na ang shape ng Pilipinas. Mindanao, as a side note, actually has three pieces. Central Mindanao, Eastern Mindanao, Western Mindanao. Kaya maraming bundok na volcanic din doon. So this is Western, Eastern Mindanao. Here. And this is yung lawit ng Mindanao. Zamboanga. So magkakahiwalay siya noon. No? Magkakahiwalay siya noon. And so on and so forth until we have something we are starting to recognize. Ang bagal tumayo ni Luzon. No? Okay. And there you have Palawan, Mindoro. Sorry, Mindoro as well came from Pangaea. Joining the rest of the group until it becomes Partitan. Then there. Tapos dumating yung mga Buaya, the form of LGUs.
And politicians.
Sorry, bawal pala yung ganun, no? I'm sorry. Okay, this is not political in any way. Okay. So,
Pero may Philippine crocodile talaga
tayo? Yes.
Meron.
Meron talaga.
You have two. 3, kasama yung political crocodile.
Medyo ayaw niyang mag-cooperate, sorry. Nagpa-fast forward na ako. Meron akong na-skip. Nope, I'm sorry. It's not responding.
Ayan, hindi tuloy yung laptop.
Oo nga, ayun. Kasi kung ano-ano sinasabi ko eh. Ayaw niya mag-umalik.
Okay.
Ayan na. sa ending na ako. Pinapatapos na ako. Sorry. If we look at more recent history, but still ancient, mga 20,000 years ago, there was an ice age. No? So alam natin na ang global warming at cooling is a natural cycle. So 20,000 years ago, there was a global cooling resulting in the current ocean levels going down 120 meters from its present level. So imbis na bumabaha, bumababa yung tubig. Because nagiging yellow. So the ice, the glaciers march towards the equator. That's 20,000 years ago. And if ocean levels go down, you will see more land. Ito yung classic land bridges theory na tinuturo sa atin sa social studies. Now, Robert Hall came up with greater island groups. Okay, it's a kind of map looking at the Philippines 20,000 years ago. So when we say greater islands, we have Greater Luzon, Greater Negros Panay, and so on and so forth. Which means yung mga magkakadikit na islands became connected, land bridges. Okay. But there are still islands that have remained isolated. Who has been to Sibuyan? Do you know where it is? Those who haven't been, do you know? Sibuyan. Okay, it's a very, very small island, right, in the south of Mindoro, and an expedition found in 5 feet of dead wood, 3 mosses, 2 orchids, found nowhere else, not even in the other islands of the Philippines. No? So, very rich, because Sibuyan has never been part of Pangaea, and has never been part of any other island in Luzon. So the only way Sibuyan could be populated was through the sweepstake method. Kung meron lang makatawid, kung meron lang makachambang, mag-rafting, mag-boating, at makarating doon. Okay, I think the channel separating Luzon and Visayas is only 2 or 3 kilometers. But the Greater Luzon fauna is very, very different from the Greater Mindanao fauna, even if it's just 2 kilometers separated. So let's take a look. Ayan. So in Greater Luzon, you have animals that have bushy tails, no? Ganito kalalaki, medyo malusog katulad ko, maraming balahibo, kulay puti, kulay itim. Yung iba maliliit, pero yung kanilang balbas sobrang haba, and they eat only earthworms. These are rats, but not the Norwegian Viking rats that we have in Manila. Vikings po yung mga yun, kaya matatapang. Mga sila sa galleon trade ships. Yung mga rats natin sa forest, we call them cloud rats. They're found only in Greater Luzon. Wala siya sa ibang greater islands. Okay. And of course, you have the iconic tamarau, the V-shaped water buffalo, found only, such a big animal, pero hindi nakatawid. found only in Greater Mindoro, Greater Palau. And then you have the bleeding heart pigeons. It's a bird. It's supposed to fly across oceans. Pero hindi niya ginagawa eh. There's no reason to fly across oceans when you have a lush forest full of food. Diba? Bakit ka alis? So namalagi siya doon. And it became endemic only to Greater Negros Panay. Maraming bleeding hearts sa Pilipinas. And they are endemic to certain islands only. Tumatango kayo, sir. Alam niyo siguro, marami tayong ganun, no? Meron nga sa Santa Ines, meron kaming na-document on the presence of the Luzon bleeding heart. We have, of course, the tarsier, no? Which I hope does not become accustomed to the resort being built. Found only in Greater Mindanao, no? Kasi Bohol was attached to Greater Mindanao noong Ice Age 20,000 years ago. Okay? So even if Greater Ice Age Islands were formed, there are still islands that remain separated. So isolation is the key. Further isolation is the present-day habitats, life zones, we call them, of our mountains. And each mountain has three very different, very distinct life zones. So we have the lowland dipterocarp forest, kung nasaan merong mga malalaking poste ng Meralco, yun ang tingin natin sa puno eh, no? Poste ng Meralco. Unfortunately, that's what people see when they see a forest. They don't see the forest, they see furniture. And then we have montan forest, the upper, the next level, which is the middle of the forest. And then the tallest of our mountains, may 3 kilometers tayo, Mount Pulag, you have a mystery wonderland of mossy forest. Have you been? Have you seen? It's my dream to climb Pulag before my back says no. Yung mga puno doon, para silang mga old people na may mga balbas, no? Pero yung balbas nila, puro mga moss. And everything is dripping wet even during the dry season. So, very different environment creates very different life forms. So, iba pa yung isolation ng islands, iba pa yung isolation as you climb the mountains. So, there are birds that will not survive the lowland. So, doon lang sila sa tuktok. And so on and so forth. So, that's why, indeed, the Philippines is very rich in terms of biodiversity. So, unfortunately, we are also considered by experts as the hottest of the hotspots. So another technical term, hotspot means you are very rich in diversity, but also very rich in threats to those diversity. So marami tayong number one sa Pilipinas. So, number one tayo sa diversity. Unfortunately, number one din tayo sa plastic waste that goes into the ocean. You know that? Okay. That's because of the sachet economy. And, you know, the use of plastics. I went to a meeting with the municipal government of Taytay. There is this councillor who's very eager to establish our humble Tungtung River. And I will plug in. Our humble Tungtung River as a protected area. And I have this coffee table book made by one of my students. That's the waterfall 20 minutes away from our school. So the municipal, so not all LGUs are, you know, this councilor is very eager to put up a protected area concerning this waterfall. Kaso nung sa meeting, nag-serve siya ng plastic bottled water. So kinausap ko siya pagkatapos. Na-realize naman niya, nag-apologize siya and everything. So yung mga ganun, no? Now some of us are businesses owners. So kumusta? 3-in-1 coffee, pancit canton, instant. I'm challenging my students eh. Sabi ko sa kanila, if you love Earth, if you profess to be a guardian of the Earth, that's one of the lines in our school motto, are you willing to give up? Piatos. Are you willing to give up your lucky me, your cup noodles? Are you willing to give up Coke? Because all of these things are in plastic. So, hottest of the hot spots. Map of the Philippine forest cover. A century ago. 70%. 1900s. Ano po yung nangyayari sa Pilipinas 1900s? Lumabas na si Apo Island, wala pa si Japanese. Okay, American period? Tama, no? That's why I don't teach history. Okay, so from the time of 1900s to the present, in just 100 years, from 70% to 3%. Before the Spaniards came, kailan po yun? Sabi ni Yoy Villame. 1500s, di ba? Wala pa ang Spaniards. Incidentally, that's one of the causes of degradation. Human greed and hubris. Who is crazy enough to call something their own just because they saw it? This land is mine for King Philip. Okay, eh paano yung mga doon na nilibing? Di ba? Oh, anyway, so, I digress. 1500s, the Philippine archipelago was 97% forest. No? So walang Puerto Galera. It's really forest, and then biglang boom, dagat. Wala man lang open space. Ganun yung Pilipinas noon. So from 1500s to 1900s, ilang taon yun? 400 years. 20% lang ang nawala.
20% lang.
And in the past 100 years, and more so in the past 50 years, we destroyed what nature was building in 50 million years. We destroyed in just 100 years. So that's how human greed can be so powerful. Now everything is mine. I don't think about my children. Kasi kung wala nang gubat, wala nang oxygen. Throw away all the data. It's as simple as that. Okay. Walang gubat, walang oxygen. Okay. We are the hottest of the hotspots. We have 750 species that are threatened. And if we study history, and we should, there are many warning signs already of what is to come. Sino nakakaalala ng ormok? Hindi pa ako buhay nun eh. So, ormok, 1991, 7,000 people died. None of them landowners. Because all the landowners were in Manila. So, ano nangyari? Most of the island has been denuded, deforested, and converted into sugarcane. I will not say excuse me or apology if you are from Negros and if you are one of those landowners. But, that's fact. Okay? It was given over to sugarcane plantations. And then, the flash floods came, typhoons, which you cannot stop. We are in a typhoon corridor. That's just how it is. Typhoons are not bad. No? They just are. Okay, so, 30 minutes. Ito palagi yung sinasabi na... Meron talaga. Ito sinasabi palagi ng mga co-teachers ko, nandiyan na sila nakatayo. Sir, time na. Okay, so... When this happened, a year after the disaster, eto na, meron ng mga NGOs, gusto nang magtanim, let's bring back the forest. Ang sagot ng councilor, we have to convince the landowners kasi ayaw nila. The landowners need data. Kapag nagtanim ba kayo, will the value of those trees be more than my sugar? Okay. Saan po ilalagay doon yung 7,000 lives lost? How do you measure a life? In songs? In coffee? Okay. So how much is a human life worth? This is all probably distant from us. Probably we are not even from the area. But these are our children's children we are talking about. Masaya dito, nasa taas tayo. We are not affected by floods. Climate change, what's that? Malamig dito, sarap, di ba? So, out of sight, out of mind. Isipin natin, pag binaha sa baba, saan pupunta yung mga tao?
Sa taas.
And we have one of the worst climate change maps. Okay? Kasi marami sa ating coastal areas. So all those millions of people will now go up to where we are. And land prices, prices of commodities, availability of jobs will all be affected. So that's the world that our children's children will be facing. if we don't do anything. So what can we do? We have here business owners. There's a lot of power in owning a business. You can influence so many lives if we do what is right. Let me share with you a little bit what I do sa mga ganitong talks when I give it to schools. So let's pretend we are back in school. How many of you want to be doctors? Wala. Di ba one of the traditional careers yon when you were young? Let's try to imagine when we were young, no matter how long ago. Doctors? Wala. Oh, yon. Engineers? Really? Wow. Pilots? Policemen? Oh, anyway, those are the traditional careers. Pag tinanong mo sa, I asked this in Assumption Antipolo, I asked this in Paref Woodrow's, I asked this in Ateneo de Manila, I will be asking this in UST next week. Ano ang careers gusto nyo? None of them will reply wildlife researcher. None of them will reply conservationist. So isa yan sa mga kakulangan. Yung mainstream education natin dapat mabago. But that's another thing. A is for apple. Wala nga tayong apple sa Pilipinas, di ba? Pero that's what we teach our kids. Okay, so things have to change all the way from education to how we do business. And what has changed? If you look at Rizal,
nasa elementary ako, gusto ko maging forest ranger.
This is Rizal, 1984. This is from Google Map, Google Earth. Okay, that's the type Triceratops. T-Rex footprint daw si Laguna Lake. It's green already. Green is not a good news for water bodies. Green means polluted. So noon pa lang polluted na siya. But what I want you to notice is what I call the white virus. Mga GI sheets, mga kalsada. Is the white virus dominant in the area? Halos wala. Nasaan si Rizal? Banda rito. We are at the doorstep. You can say we are the guardians of the Sierra Madre. So if we let wrong development come in, if we sacrifice all our forests for resorts that are masquerading as farms, then we are giving up potentially the Sierra Madre mountain range already. So that's 1984. Tignan niyo yung human virus ng 2020. And it chose to not cooperate. There. See the human virus? Sobrang laki ng expansion ng human virus. Okay, we are worried about the COVID pandemic, but I think we should be more worried about this. What is happening? What are we doing to ourselves? And so without people like you and me who are willing to resist what is called progress, the wrong notion of it, then this area will soon succumb to the white virus, to the cement virus. So yan po ang future ng Rizal, unless we do something about it. Okay, for context, andito tayo. Malapit na malapit na malapit na. Now we are somewhere here. Right now, we are at the border. Okay, a lot of things to think about, and hopefully this morning we can establish connections. We can talk about what to do. The science is there. We already know what to do. Global warming, bike more, ride less. Diba alam na natin yan? Magdala ng eco bag. Question is, are we willing to do it? So it's not anymore a question of science. Because we already know what to do. The data is complete. It's a question of values. Are we willing to do it? Good morning po.
Sinabi niyo, sir, as a Gen Z, parang ang dami kong kailangan pang malaman about what you said from the biodiversity at us as guardians of Rizal. And alam ko po, lahat po tayo merong kanya-kanyang platforms. We have our own influence. And ayun, pag nilay-nilayan natin yung sinabi ni Sir Henry. And ngayon, mas mapapalalim pa natin at mas mapapalago pa natin ang usapin tungkol dyan with our panel discussion. So let me introduce po to you our moderator for today. So she is the co-founder and president of the One Kainta Food Program and the co-founder of Sustainable